Talking about supporting warriors in our community that sacrificed everything for our safety and freedom after the explosion in West Texas just over a year ago. Linda and Jeff Venable were inspired to make a difference, and they join me now in studio. Thanks for being here today.
Hi.
Linda, you were a firefighter for 33 years and are now retired, but what was it about West that inspired you to start support for firefighters? I mean, you didn't really have much connection specifically to this group of guys.
Actually, Captain Kenny Harris was a friend of mine, and
okay.
I had worked with him back in the 80s, so I did have a connection there. And, you know, we had plans to retire. You know, we bought a great house out at Robeson Ranch and really wanted to just enjoy all of that. And then these things started happening. It was the West, it was Stan Wilson, it was, you know, just a whole, the situation in Arizona, and these things got us to thinking, you know, what can we do, and so this was born, you know.
Yeah.
It just...
So you were able to get your husband also interested, and maybe you were right out of the gate. I doubt you had to do much convincing, Jeff, but your mission is to run 3,500 miles across the United States to raise awareness of the cause, and you leave in just a few short weeks. I noticed you stretching over here. What is this going to be like for you?
Yeah, this should be a really interesting experience. I of course, never run 3,500 miles. I've run, you know, several marathons. I've run over 100 marathons, one in each state. I ran across the state of Tennessee sort of as a test run last year.
Yeah.
But there's a big difference between 9 days in a row and 100 ultra marathons in a row.
How many miles a day are you?
About 35 miles a day. I'm just hoping my feet are tough enough, man.
Yeah. Are they?
No, of course they are.
So, Linda, what is your role in this run?
Well, I think of myself as the logistics officer,
mm-hmm.
and basically I just find food, water, and we're carrying our shelter with us, but there are things that go along with having we have a small RV, because we're taking the dogs, and we needed a place, you know, because there are long stretches throughout the country where there's no services that we'll be able to tap into.
Where are you going to be stopping across the country?
Well, our first goal is Colorado Springs. There's a memorial there. And then our second goal is 9/11 for that ceremony. But along the way, we'll stop and visit some friends. We'll maybe stop in on a family member here and there.
Yeah.
But only the ones that are on the route.
Right.
Yeah.
Keeping it real.
Right.
So what will the money be used for? You're donating this money to the cause. What exactly, or what are you hoping that it gets specifically used for?
Well, 100% of all donations go to our charities. And we had originally thought, well, we would grassroots it and make decisions ourselves, but we quickly found out that that's a very difficult thing to do. So we have decided on three charities that we wanted to focus our efforts into. One is for the widows and survivors of fallen firefighters across the country. The other is for safety equipment for volunteers, which a lot of people don't understand, but 3/4 of the firefighters across the country are volunteers. And so they have to raise money to buy safety equipment and to buy their the clothing that they wear to protect themselves and things like that.
Yeah, they also run the risk of, in something like West, where you've got insurance companies and federal aid, kind of people with the best of intentions don't know exactly how this all plays out. And you have people who are in desperate need who have to wait for a lot of red tape to get cleared up. So
exactly.
There's always a need for that immediate emergency help.
Exactly. And then there's one other group called the Sons of the Flag that is fairly new, and they were, I guess, established by some Navy SEALs, and what they do is they fund burn victim research, which is important for military people. It's important for anybody in this room that might be in a car accident,
right,
or a house fire or something, but it's also something that's important to the firefighters across the country.
Well, thank you so much for taking the initiative to do this, Jeff. Good luck, man. Good luck. You've got a good woman behind you.
Thanks.
Lynn and Jeff are going to be leaving on May 26th for their adventure. To find out more and to donate to the cause, go to their website, supportforfirefighters.com, or you can check them out on Facebook, Support for Firefighters. Jeff and Linda, thanks for being here this morning. We wish you really all the success and happiness as you go through this process.
Thank you.
Calling all...